Okay. Always that sense of humor, Galaxy Trail. Greetings, weird part of YouTube. Sakura Solo here. And I have been waiting a long, long time for this demo. Freedom Planet 2. Now, anybody who has listened to me for a little bit or seen my choice in clothing, you probably know that I'm a huge Freedom Planet fan. I actually even bought this t-shirt during the Teespring campaign, before they even had their merchandising website on Galaxy Trail. So, now, I am super excited to try the demo for Freedom Planet 2. Oh gosh, I cannot tell you guys how excited I am. Okay. They said there might be some issues with the controller because it hasn't been implemented yet, but I'm gonna see what I can do. Oh, this looks gorgeous. The Frost Knight. You know, I don't like Naraly as a character so much, but after seeing her demo video, I think it's a playable character as opposed to an NPC. She has some interesting mechanics, but I'm gonna go with my girl Lilac. Okay. Dragon Cyclone, Hair Whip, and Dragon Boost. I also understand that Lilac has an interesting new move where you can stop your Dragon Boost midway and pop off the residual energy as an attack. That should be fun. And that should be interesting. Okay, let's see. Auto Guarding. Okay. Gym Booster. Custom. I'm not aware of many of the items in this game yet, so I'm not gonna go custom. Let's just go normal and see what happens. Oh, I'm excited. I am so excited. Let's do this.
Cyclone.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there's that Dragon Boost. Oh! Oh yeah, I saw that in the video. Oh. Okay. Well, it seems to be working fine with this controller, actually.
Cyclone.
Of course, to let you guys know, I am using an Xbox 360 controller, the Rock Candy to be exact.
Cyclone.
Okay. There we go. Kind of learning the controls a little bit, but getting there. Oh, this is just absolutely gorgeous. Oh, and the music is great too. Look at these backgrounds. Look at those animations. Oh, if this isn't the final product, I eagerly await what the final product will look like. Look at this! I know they said that there might be some problems with the controls, but I'm not finding them.
Cyclone!
Whoa! Okay! Ooh, wrong way. Oh, there's that. Oh, there's that midway attack with the Dragon Boost. I am gonna say that Dawn Bennett, she does really great as the voice of Lilac. I love how in this sequel, Lilac actually sounds a little bit more mature. That is voice acting skill. Right there, when it's like, okay, Lilac's a little older, I'm gonna make her sound more mature. That is...
Cyclone!
That's just epic. Whoa, what was that?
Cyclone!
know I'm just kind of blasting through and not really exploring a lot, but...
Yes!
Auto-guarding. Okay. I am not entirely sure what that does.
Cyclone!
Okay, Butcherbait. There we go. Also, I love how this is Dragon Valley, but it definitely looks like an updated look. It still looks like Dragon Valley, but it definitely looks like it could be a different segment of it that was unexplored in the first Freedom Planet. Or, you know, for all we know, this could be like a different season where there are different plants growing. Oh, and that music, it's like, oh, there was that psycho again.
Cyclone!
Oh! Like, I'm actually standing in the tree leaves? Is that a little bit of Minecraft inspiration I'm seeing? Oh. Oh, what's this?
Cyclone.
Oh! 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 Landscape damage, okay. Oh, okay. Oh, that wasn't a shield at all. Oh, boss fight, yeah, ooh, hi. Okay, alright, I can see where that interrupt attack, as I'm gonna call it, actually did wonders for doing some boss damage right there. I'm taking a lot of hits that I probably don't need to be taking, but I'm just kind of in wonder of how amazing this game is. It's like absolutely, I love it. It's gorgeous. It's amazing. Oh my gosh. Okay, let's try with another character now. Let's go with Carol. Oh gosh, this is just, I have no words for this. Okay, so she has like a disc attack, which I saw in the, Carol is a little bit more stiff than Lilac, but at the same time, it's like, if you know how to use her, she's a total bad butt. It's like, no, she doesn't have Lilac's speed, or necessarily Lilac's power. Ooh. Oh, was that an item box with extra crystals? Wow. Oh, Christ. Also, we got the physics from the first Freedom Planet. I know a lot of people actually complained about that. Oh, there were more of those boxes back there, but I missed them. But I kind of like the physics, because when you consider the fact this is on another planet, and it's already furry anyway, it's like, I think it could be kind of forgiving with the physics. And we have Carol's motorcycle. Oh, did I just sacrifice the motorcycle for that attack? Lovely job, Sakura. Whoa. Ah! I walked into that one. Because if there is one thing that I've learned about Freedom Planet, and I love it too, there is a learning curve to each stage. But not a terrible learning curve. It's like it's just right as you progress through the game. Oh, okay. Alright, I'm not as adept with Carol as I am with Lilac, but also, did you see how that bridge glue? Oh boy, I am taken back by that. Because apparently, I am very heavily reminded of a while back when I started learning about the beta of Sonic the Hedgehog 2 for the Sega Genesis and how Hidden Palace was originally supposed to be one of the stages in that game. But apparently it was cut from the final game, and one of the main attributes in that level, aesthetically, was a bridge that glowed some as you crossed it. Oh, I'm terrible. It's Carol. But, and it was like a bridge made of emerald or something similar. Oh, I love that little Carol animation when she's, like, riding the air. It's like you can see that Carol is gaining skill. It's like, it's these little things where you're actually seeing them grow up. But yeah, so apparently the glowing bridge was actually such, I can't quite get to that. Well, I could if I got off these springs, but I'm gonna move on to the boss. Huh? Oh, I think this guy's gonna demolish me playing as Carol. But, yeah, like I said, I am not adept with Carol. Oh, how am I still alive? Ah, there we go. I knew I was gonna bite it. Alright, that, I should've known better than that. I should've been learning more. I'm just so taken with this. It's like, I have waited for this for so freaking long, you have no idea. Alright, I really love this update Battle of the Boss theme. There we go!
Victory!
Also, I'm wondering what the significance of the cards are gonna be in this game, because I remember in the first game, it allows you to find all kinds of unlockables, like soundtracks, sound clips, concept art, things of that nature. It was, like, so cool. Alright, I'm gonna make sure that... Okay. Apparently, because that final sound effect when you defeat the boss, it, like, it's so loud. And I don't want blowing out you guys' ears, but... Okay, let's try Mila next. Mila. Now her... I am not very skilled with her at all, because... Oh. I don't know, her attacks were just so different in the first game, but at the same time, it's like, it looks like she's a lot more aggressive this time, a lot more offensive. Which I can tell by that kung fu stance that she has been doing some training. Like I said, little details leading up to character development. You can tell she's still a puppy, though, in her mannerisms. Huh? Okay, that was interesting. I don't think that was invincibility. It was the invincibility theme, but... Apparently, I was creating crystals to collect, I think, unless I misunderstood that. But, you know, while I never was very skilled in the first game with Mila, okay, with Mila as a character, a playable character, I was always interested about her story, and I hope to see that further developed in this game, because Mila, it's like, okay, you have this sweet little puppy girl, and she's out in the woods all by herself, and her best friend is a stump. And it's like, okay.
Ooh.
This again. But she's got these special powers. It's like, okay, who are her parents? Why does she have powers? Is it possible that she was abandoned because of those powers? Maybe her parents were afraid, hey, she's gonna get shunned, she's gonna get us in trouble, people are gonna think that she's like some kind of a demon or something. I don't know. Or maybe, so maybe they like took her out in the forest and left her because they were afraid of the retribution they might get from that. I'm not entirely sure. It's kind of hard to say. Or you know, because apparently she doesn't have any animosity toward her parents though. Or maybe they were trying to get her away from the people with superpowers. I don't know, because apparently her powers are not exactly something that are common in this world because they're not bound to an element, I want to say. Okay, there we go. Because this world seems to... it seems to revolve around elements. Okay. Ow. Okay, you would think that I would learn to look out for that attack. Okay, this guy's gonna destroy me. Unless I can pull something out of my butt real quick. Never mind. Yep, it's official. I bite as Mila. Okay, I just kind of matrixed that dodge. But yeah, I could go on and on about, you know, I actually tried to get out of the way of that attack that time. I could go on and on about why I'm so curious about Mila's story, but it's like... oh boy, what does this say about me if the first boss is beating my rear end this badly? There we go. Alright, sounds like her voice is maturing a little bit as well. So, that's good on Mila's voice actor. Alright, we got one more character to roll with. Alright, we got Double Jump, Ice Staff, and Frost Darts. Okay. Alright, let's roll.
Freeze!
Okay. Like I said, did not entirely care for her as an NPC. She actually did get on my nerves a little bit, gonna flat out say that. But, as a playable character, it looks like she might have some interesting mechanics. Okay, there we go. I think I am starting to get the hang of it just a little bit.
Freeze.
Ah. I probably could have gone on without grabbing that, but it's like, meh, it's there. Alright, there's this thing again. I have not entirely figured it out, but it's like, okay, we'll roll with it. Alright, I wanna... Okay, I can see now that the faster you move and the more ground you cover while that is going on, it's like, okay, that's the more crystals you'll get. Oh, I'll tell you, that Crystal Hoarder achievement in the first game, I actually got it on both the PC version and the Wii U version before they edited it where you only had to get 6,000 crystals instead of... Oh, yeah, clear that path and then go this way. Yeah, I actually cleared it back when it was 7,000 crystals that you had to get. And it was a pain in the butt, but I done it. I haven't finished all the achievements on the Wii U version yet, but I have gotten all the achievements in Freedom Planet on the Steam version for PC. Oh, you were such a snob. I mean, I'm sorry, Narrowly, but you are... I mean, yeah, you finally admitted where you were wrong with Lilac, and... Well, you never outright admitted it, but you did secede to the fact that you guys needed Lilac's help. When she had to go inspect the, mineral. And ended up finding that other version of Syntax that was not Brevin's. And ended up fighting that Psycho Hollow Dragon. For some reason, the name of that stage is definitely escaping me. I don't know why. But I do know this, the first time that I saw that holographic dragon in that stage as the boss, it's like when it first appeared, when you just saw that massive blue eye showing up in the darkness, it's like, that scared the living crud out of me. It's like, oh, I gotta fight this thing, how big is it? I can't even see the entire thing. Because see, here's the funny thing, humans have this fear of the unknown. And not being able to see the entire dragon.
Freeze.
That... Oh, gosh, I walked right into that. That kind of played on that fear.
Freeze.
Okay. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Still getting over the allergy attack a little bit. I might actually take this guy the first round as Narrowly. Wow. Of course, then again, fighting him as the three other previous characters, I've actually kind of learned him to some extent, so it's like, that might be playing a factor in this. Then again, it's like, I can see that Narrowly concedes when she ultimately needs to, but until that point, it's like, I mean, I do respect her... what would you call it? I do respect her confidence, but I do have concerns of the trouble that that could get somebody into. Okay, so that was the demo for Freedom Planet 2, and I have thoroughly enjoyed it. If this is just the demo, imagine what the final game is going to be like. Galaxy Trail has done an amazing job so far. Oh my gosh, I cannot begin to explain how much I love what I'm seeing so far. It's like, I absolutely fell in love with the first Freedom Planet, and this is just taking it and running with it. I just absolutely... I don't know what else to say. It's like... It's like, I was such a huge fan. I know I sound like I'm repeating myself, but it's like, I was such a huge fan of the first Freedom Planet, and then this comes along, and it's like, yes. I mean, it's like, usually the sequel is not better than the first. You know, that has been a running thing with movies, with video games, but... You know, here's the funny thing that I'm noticing. With the Sonic franchise, that cycle was actually kind of broken, because Sonic 2 was actually better than Sonic 1. And Freedom Planet originally started out as a Sonic fan game before it became its own thing. And so Freedom Planet was definitely heavily inspired by Sonic at that point. When it became its own standalone game, and Freedom Planet is also breaking that cycle, because from what I'm seeing here, with just the demo, Freedom Planet 2 is definitely going to be better than Freedom Planet 1. I mean, obviously the first Freedom Planet is going to have a special place in everybody's hearts, like the first Sonic was. Sonic the Hedgehog 1 for the Sega Genesis, rather. But, I mean, I'm just blown away. I mean, maybe I am partial because I'm a Freedom Planet fan already. But even if you're not a Freedom Planet fan, look at the graphics here. I mean, that just makes you want to... want to pack up everything and go away. You know, it makes you forget all your troubles. In a way, it's like, alright, maybe that wasn't the best terminology. I know I'm having a lot of pauses because I'm having a lot of trouble explaining this. But simply put, this is doing what a video game is meant to do. It's captivating you. Or at least it's captivating me. And it's definitely taking all the things that were positive about the first Freedom Planet, adding positive things to it, and finessing some of the things that needed finessing. And like I said, I find it funny they said that I might have problems with my controller because there was something not quite finished with the programming of the controller mapping. But I didn't have any problems with this, so it's like, okay, fair enough. But yeah, so that was the demo for Freedom Planet 2. I loved what I saw. The graphics were great, the music was amazing, the voice acting was excellent, because we can see little bits of character development even in the voice acting, because they sound a little bit older, but they still sound like themselves. It's like the voice actors are not trying too hard, and then you see little bits of their character development in their actions, but at the same time they're still them. It's not over the top. And the only thing that I can find negative, and I'm flat out gonna say it, I don't care for Lilac's new character design. There, I said it. I prefer her old character design from Freedom Planet 1. There, I said it. Alright? I mean, the new design is growing on me. But, I mean, it's not to a level like Sonic Boom Knuckles growing on me. That took a long time, but it eventually did grow on me. But, yeah, I really don't... I sound like I'm contradicting myself. It's hard to explain what I mean. I'm not partial to Lilac's new design. I prefer the old one, but the new design is growing on me. So, all the other character designs look excellent. Looking at Galaxy Trail's website, I really like how Mare Zhao has a bigger hat. You have no idea how long Project Dark Fox and I were making jokes about plus five this, plus five that. Excuse me. Yeah, Mare Zhao was definitely one of our favorite characters. But, I love how he said that he was going to serve everybody chow mein and then he served everybody sushi. Don't think I didn't catch that. But, anyway, I'm going to shut up now. That was the demo for Freedom Planet 2. I hope y'all enjoyed it. I hope you go to galaxytrail.com and try it for yourself. I'll put a link down in the description. So, y'all be blessed and stay blessed.